Good morning, dear students. How is going on for you all? I hope everything is going on well for you. During this lockdown, I hope you all are studying well at home. So be at home, be safe. Okay? So welcome back to our lesson, that is matter around us, pure. So we have seen various terms and topics related to this topic, related to these lessons. So we have started in my last class. I have explained you the separation techniques for the homogeneous and the heterogeneous mixture. So the first separation technique for the homogeneous mixture we have seen, that is for the true solution particular, we have seen that is evaporation technique. The all process of the evaporation technique which is followed for the homogeneous mixture like true solution we have explained with the help of the proper diagram. And wherever this is used we have seen this is also called as a crystallization. Why it is called crystallization? That is why let you know. As well as various things related to the evaporation technique and how evaporation process takes place into our environment and what are the factors on which the evaporation depends, we have seen. So now we are going to talk about one important separation technique which is followed for the suspension. Suspension means what? You are knowing students, you can go back and again you can revise the same. Suspension is also made up of two kinds of components, that is solute and solvent. But here the difference is the solute particles are not able to dissolve into the water because it is heterogeneous mixture. The solid particles are larger than 100 nanometer. We have seen in the solution the particle size is less than 1 nanometer. The particle size of the colloidal solution is ranging from 1 nanometer to 100 nanometer, but the particle size the suspension is more than 100 nanometer, and so that these particles are easily seen by the naked eyes. Okay, so what are the techniques we follow to separate the suspension techniques, suspension or the solution of suspension? What techniques we follow in our day-to-day life? See, in the olden days, example is a muddy water. Nowadays, water comes for our tap, or the tap water is muddy. So what we follow the techniques to separate the impurities present in it in the form of dust? What techniques we follow? In olden days, or now also we can follow. It's not necessary in olden days it is followed so normally. But nowadays we have a RO system at home. Water purifier we have a half good quality. So we are getting the clean water during this rainy season also. But what are the process to follow to separate the components, the suspended particles? How can we separate from it? First of all, suspension is one kind of unstable solution. Means if you will mix it together, then what happens? If you will keep it undisturbed for a long time in one corner, then what can happen? You can see the particles, the solid particles you will find are settled down. Okay? And above the particles, there will be a clean liquid you will be able to form. So there is one common technique which is used at home. That is sedimentation and decantation. Sediment means what? The solid mass which is settled down into the utensil, that is called as sedimentation. And pouring that above clean liquid into the another utensil, that is called as a decantation. So you have already seen in your earlier classes the process of sedimentation and decantation. Okay, this sedimentation and decantation process can be more faster by using alum. Do you know student alum? In Marathi we say turti for it. Okay, turti. This is there, which is little milky, means whitish in color, not complete white, but it is milky. The color of it is milky. So if you will put it into the water for very small period of time, if you put it into the water, then what happens? The particles which are present as a solute into this suspension, these particles will get, means I'll show you how it will get to know. See, if this is the utensil and this is water and some suspended particles are present in it in the suspension, then if you will put for small amount the alum in it, then what will happen? If this is the particle of alum, then this will dissolve into the water. Right, this alum will dissolve into the water, and what will happen? These particles, solute particles in a suspension, will accumulate particle will get surrounded by the dust particle or by the impurity, then it will become heavier. As it will become heavier, it will settle down. It will settle down. Means sedimentation process can be fastened because of use of alum. Okay, so this is the sedimentation and decantation process. Now we will go for the after every type of solution. I told you that this cannot be separated by the filtration technique. This cannot be separated by the filtration technique, or this can be separated by the filtration technique. As we have seen in the evaporation technique, the solute particles are too small, which can pass through the filter paper. But here, the suspended part, these particles of the solution, the solute particles of the suspension, are too large to be at the filter paper. So here is one diagram. With the help of the diagram, I would like to know. So there is one utensil kept. Understood? And above utensil, there is one funnel. Funnel, you are knowing, student. So funnel is kept, and above it, the filter paper is kept. This is filter paper, the diagram of filter paper, which has a small pores on it through which only liquid can pass. Understood? Small pores are there. So what will happen? We will make a cone of this filter paper. Okay, cone of the filter paper. Diagram show. We will make a cone of the filter paper, and below that we will keep one another beaker. We have to separate the solute particles from the solvent. So to accumulate this solvent, we will have another beaker over here. And what we will do? We will allow to pour that suspension onto the filter paper. As filter paper will have a small holes, through that only the liquid particles will come down, and the particles which are too large, which are greater than 100 nanometer, which will be accumulate on the filter paper. Okay, so such particles which will accumulate on the filter paper will be said as a residue. Understood? Solid mass will be formed. Okay, that is called as a residue, and the water particles which will come down into the beaker or into any utensil, that is called as a filtrate. Do you understand, students? So suspended particles, or the type of suspension that is a solution, heterogeneous mixture, that is suspension, can be clean or can be separate out its component by the filtration technique. Okay, so this is the filtration technique. I tried to explain in further class and explain you another type of